damselfly nymph, and this is a pattern that that I came up with, and that I've caught quite a few fish on it. I've actually found days where this fly outperformed the other damselfly nymphs we tie. Not always, but anyway, I'm going to tie it on a size 8 Gamagatsu S10S. And for thread, I'm going to use Semperfly's waxed and brown olive. And I'm going to just start my thread right up here behind the eye. I'm going to advance it quickly down to the bend, so I'm not worrying about making nice, even touching thread wraps. I'm going to use for a tail some Sculpin Olive Marabou, Woolly Booger Marabou. And if you ever look at a damselfly nymph, they have a very short three-pronged tail. So you could actually do your tail with three pieces of pheasant tail to make it more lifelike. Now, I don't think it moves as well. So they do have a very short tail, regardless of what you're going to use for your tail material. So I'm going to tie this in right up by the eye, keep it up at a 45 degree angle as I advance it back, and that'll keep it right on top of my hook shank. Okay, and then I'm going to come in here and even it up. So that looks pretty good. Okay, now I like to put a little bit of flash in this tail, and the color I like to use, I've lost the package. But this is actually, I think it's called black. Let's see if I can get it focused in there. There we go. So you can see it has a lot of green in it, but I believe it's called black crystal flash. And I don't like to use a lot of it, so I'm just going to take one strand here. Put it up under my thread, lift my thread, bring it up right up on top, and then I'll go ahead and tie down one side. So, get all this out of the way. So as I come back, this is a really long piece. I'm going to keep it up a little bit because the thread tends to pull it down. Okay, and then while my thread is back here, I'm going to pull the other one straight down my side of the hook, make sure it's positioned, and wrap that in. And then I can come in with my scissors and I can go ahead and cut these off even with the tail. Okay, so now that's all the flash I like to put in mine. All right, now the next thing I'm going to do are eyes, and I'm going to use plastic beads and some 25-pound mono, just whatever you want to use. I like something big enough to fill the hole inside the bead. So I'm just going to take a small piece, about maybe 3/4 of an inch long, and then I'll take my hemostats. And the farther I grab this down in the jaws, the wider the space between the eyes is going to be. So if I went way down there, I'd have a very wide space. If I went way up here, I'd have a very small space. So I like it about right there for a size, a fly this size. Okay, and so I'm going to go ahead and just get it straightened in there, clamp it. Okay, and then what I'll do is I have my beads here on my table, and for this one I'll just use the turquoise colored beads. And I've had a lot of success with red beads, but I know that damselflies don't have red eyes. So I've cut my mono off, so it's about maybe 2-3 bead lengths longer. And then I'll just come in with a lighter and melt this. I think my lighter just ran out. Okay, but you see I left a little bit of a bead on the outside. That kind of seals it in there. Gives you the look of a pupil, right? Okay, let's see. All right, so now the next one, I'm going to come in, grab my other bead. So I just have them laying flat on the table, and I just stick the end of the mono through the hole, and they're very easy to pick up that way. Cut this off short. There we go. I'll go ahead and give this one a little bit more heat. Okay, so those are my eyeballs. Okay, now the way I like to attach them, I just kind of hold them. I want them to be a little bit back from the hook eye. And you'll see why. So I'll advance my thread back. And then do just a couple of wraps kind of diagonally. And then I can bring another wrap around. And then I can manipulate them pretty easily. So I want to make sure that they're centered and straight. Once I have them in position, then I'll go ahead and figure eight a few wraps. And when they're secure, now I'll come under the eye, over the shank, under the eye, over the shank. So now my eyes are secure. If you really wanted to, you could put some super glue on them or something like that, but I think they're pretty good. All right, so I'm going to bring my thread all the way back to right at the base of my tail. For a body on this fly, I used to dub them, but now I do turkey biots. So this is a kind of an olive turkey feather. And I'm just going to pull one biot off. And you can't really use a goose biot for a size 8 hook. It's really hard to find goose biot that's that long. Turkey works the same way. You can see the notch in the back of the feather there. So that if the notch is facing backwards, then towards the tail, then when I wrap, I will have the rib coming up. But the other thing I want to do, I want to tie this in almost perpendicular to my hook shank. So I'm going to pop it in right at the back. And then I'll wrap the tip. But I want the turkey feather to be almost perpendicular. All right, now I want to build a little bit of a taper. So my thorax is going to come 2/3 up the shank. All right, so I'll come up to 2/3 and then I'll wrap back down 3/4 of the way. I'll come back up. And I'll go back down about halfway. Come back up. So this is 8/0 wax thread, so it's building my taper fairly quickly. Now down about 1/4. Back up, and now I'm just kind of eyeballing it. I just want to create that little bit of a taper. Okay, and that's fine. And just go ahead and get my thread out of the way. Anytime I use biots, I always use super glue. And so I'll just paint that right on my thread wraps. Don't need a ton, but it's good to have. It will definitely hold your biot and make your fly last a few more fish. Okay, now I'll use my hackle pliers, even though turkey biots are probably long enough that I don't need to. I want to make sure that lays down flat the way it was facing. Okay, so now with turkey, I have to start spacing my wraps farther and farther away quicker just because it gets wide really fast, but I want that rib to pop up. So if I don't do that, my wraps will actually suppress that leading edge, and it'll make my rib disappear. Okay. So I want to wrap right around the front edge of my biot. And then you can see I'm using my thread to actually cut through. Off it comes. Alright, so the next material is going to go in here is pheasant. It's been dyed kind of an olive color. And, you know, damselfly nymphs only have 6 legs. But if I only do 6 strands of pheasant, I can't make a thick enough thorax cover. So I've actually got about 10 legs. So I just pull those off perpendicular. I'm going to cut the funny stuff off the end. All my tips are even. And to measure this from the 2/3 points, I want my legs to be about the same length as my tail. I'm going to set this down, and then I'm just going to do a couple of wraps to make sure that my pheasant is going back about as long as my tail is. And then I'll bring this up to right behind the eyes. And then I'll bring it back. I'll do a couple of wraps, and this just ties it in just a little bit better. And then I'll come in with my scissors and cut it short. That also added a little bit of girth to my thorax. I'm gonna make sure it's tied down nice and tight. All right, now for my thorax, I am gonna dub it. I'm gonna use brown ice dub, which I'm sure most of you are familiar with. It's got a lot of green properties to it. I'm not exactly sure why they call it brown, but anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and dub this on. I'm going to dub it on fairly tight. I used to tie damsels kind of bushy, and they work. They caught fish, but you know, if you look at a damselfly, they're not thick bushy bugs. They're kind of streamlined and 6 legs, 3 tails, thin abdomen, and then they have a fairly pronounced wing case. Okay, so I'll start with that. If I need to add more, I certainly can. Slide your noodle up. I'm going to come in front of the eyes. I want a little bit more thorax on this, so I'm going to go ahead and add just a little bit more dubbing. All right, so now I want to bring my pheasant forward. Grab all your fibers. Bring them up between the eyes, and then I want to take my nail and kind of flatten these out so that they kind of cover the whole area through there. Okay, and then once I've got them kind of like I want them, I'm going to come and do one wrap right behind the eye. And now I'm going to bring my thread up, and I'm going to do one wrap right in front of the eye. Try not to bend any of your fibers. Okay, so now I want to separate my legs, so it doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to look about right. So I'm going to bring half to one side and do one wrap, half to the other side and do one wrap. All right, and the reason I only did one wrap on each one is you can see that thread kind of changes the color of everything. Okay, now I'm going to advance my thread forward. I'm going to go ahead and whip finish right behind the eye. Okay, so we're almost done. I'm going to try to spread my legs out a little bit to the side. Okay, and now I'm going to use some UV. And I like to use a little thicker UV, but with pheasant tail, it's going to be porous. So if I put my thicker UV on there, a lot of it's just going to soak right down into the pheasant tail. So if I take some thin, so this is the bone dry, the Solarez bone dry. If I just put a little layer of this and hit it with the torch, then it will create like a barrier on top. And then when I throw my my thicker UV on there, it won't soak in. So if I'm putting UV on like scudback or something like that, doing some sort of nymph, it doesn't matter because it's not a porous material, but pheasant tail certainly is. And so I'm just going to get, this is Semperfly's No Tack, but it's a little bit thicker. Even though it says thin, it's still what I would consider sort of a thick UV. Okay, so I'm just going to put that right where I want it to be. And just kind of get it set up. Hit it with the torch. Probably not a necessary step, but I like to do it. Okay, so that is my version of a damselfly nymph. Worked really well. I think probably the one with the red eyes has worked better than any other color, but you know, you can play around with them and get it the way you like it. But I'll be taking some of these to Henry's to fish in just a few days. So thanks for watching.